A local daycare owner is upset and says the state of North Dakota isn't giving her a fair chance to reopen her facility after three kids wandered off.
Some of the parents of the children involved are speaking out as well, saying the owner is getting a bad rap. Valley News Team's Joseph Ojo tells how these people hope to come together to help revive the daycare, which they say prior to the incident had a clean record.
This April, three kids from Curious Kids Daycare in North Fargo slipped out onto the busy 19th Avenue North before being helped back to the facility.
This is the only thing that's on my record since 2005.
She didn't expect that the state would not hear her appeal and make such a rash decision to shut her daycare down.
I was shocked, actually. I didn't think it was going to come to that. It was really disheartening, and probably cried the first time I heard about it.
They have forced four full-time and three part-time staff out of their jobs. They have forced 25 families to have to find care.
I asked Raisler if the state could possibly be targeting her daycare, and she replied that while it is hard to know why they made their decision, she feels her daycare is being used as an example.
Does one incident on an otherwise good record shut down a program now going forward?
Raisler says the incident has surely made her and her staff more vigilant of all children. And even parents of the three kids who made their way onto the street did not put up a fight nor wanted to take their kids out of the daycare.
But they had trust that we had made corrections, that we would not let it happen again.
And it became evident that the state really wanted to make an example of this daycare.
Other parents are standing behind Raisler and her daycare too.
I mean, to be shut down, it's inconsistent with other daycares that have had kids get out.
They tell us it is very hard to find new daycares.
They aren't willing to settle for what they're finding.
Nowhere has a large outdoor space, and that's extremely important for me.
And that they feel powerless because the closure is causing inconvenience.
I'm a single mom. I get done with work at 5, so I'm not able to pick them up until 5:30, maybe 6.
Now looking at close to $30,000 in legal fees just to get her appeal heard and not denied, Raisler and several parents are advocating for all daycares so that the state will not have a lot of power over a business with only one infraction.
If there's another case like this, are we going to be shutting down every daycare that has a similar instance? That's a pretty slippery slope, and soon nobody's going to have daycare.
In Fargo, Joseph Ojo, Valley News Live.
Raisler's next appeal hearing is in October, and she's hoping to spark changes in the law by sharing her story.